Howdy, I'm Nate, and in today's video I'm going to go over how to cut wood with a handsaw. The key to getting a straight and accurate cut with a handsaw is practicing the proper technique. To do that, I'm going to be using this Western miter back saw, which cuts on the push. Now, when we approach a workpiece, we're going to approach it differently than we approach a workbench. We're gonna approach a work piece as if we're ready to engage mortal combat. Hiya! That's right, a karate style stance, where if you're right-handed, you'll put your right foot slightly back and your left foot slightly forward, so that way we can be open to be able to move the saw blade back and forth over the work piece. Now if you're left-handed, just reverse that, and either way, keep your knees slightly bent so that way you can engage it with a little bit of fluidity. Now, it comes to holding the saw itself, it seems like it would be an intuitive thing to do, grip the handle. What's more? Well, actually, saws are best gripped with the forefinger forward along either the spine or the handle, and the thumb matching that, with three fingers wrapping around the handle. Now this gives us a bit of stability from the saw moving left to right because we don't want any lateral movement. Additionally, our grip should not be that of a white knuckle death grip, but that of holding a baby bird in the hand where we don't want it to let it go, but we don't want to crush it like Lennie. With that done, we can work on the focus of our body mechanics for our forearm locking into the saw blade itself. And we're gonna want to move our saw blade back and forth in a straight line. And to do that, we keep our forearm locked in line with the saw blade itself. And we allow ourselves to articulate at the shoulder and the elbow to keep that going. Now we don't want any chicken wings in here. Keep it down and keep it in line along the side of your body. If you start going out to the side, your cut's gonna get offline. Now the next thing we need to do is approach the workpiece to actually make our cut. When making our cut, we're going to want to start on the far edge of our workpiece. And we could use our thumb to guide the saw blade into the exact spot where we want the saw to cut. And when it's there, we can leave the thumb actually there, pushing against the side of the blade, not the teeth part of the blade. And that will help keep us from getting any unwanted lateral movement. Now we're starting on the far edge, so that way we can establish a groove quicker. If we have the saw flat across the full workpiece, it's gonna take a lot longer to establish a groove, which might end up with our saw wandering and damaging the edge of our workpiece. In doing so, I like to draw the saw backwards. Now as this is a push saw, it doesn't cut on the draw. At least not that much. And in drawing it backwards, we establish a small line and we push forward a little bit without digging in too much. Try to glide across the workpiece. And once we've established that, we can work the groove across the top of the workpiece so that way the groove can stretch across and establish a nice straight line for us to follow. Now that the saw has made it across the workpiece, we can level off our saw, remove our thumb, and continue cutting to our marked line or through the workpiece. And that is how you cut with the handsaw. How did I do on this video? Did I forget anything important? If so, leave it in the comments down below. Till next time.